E anche a Oslo è giunto il momento di una top 5. E poi basta sta pace, sta ecologia. Finalmente ci ritroviamo tra animali imbalsamati, spade, pistole e memorabilia della Seconda Guerra Mondiale. Ma anche qui da Pentagon abbiamo trovato 5 oggetti che ci sono molto piaciuti. E cominciamo da questo mashup tra una maschera teschio e una maschera d'alieno. Ecco a voi DJ Aladdin. Ah, l'espressione sarò il bastone della tua vecchiaia. Beh, non so voi, ma se proprio ci deve essere una persona che diventa il bastone della mia vecchiaia,
io
secondo
no.
me, no, deve essere Master Yoda. Seconda posizione era lato sciaffo. Vabbè, dai, qualcosa di almeno vagamente militare in questa top 5 dei migliori oggetti da Pentagon. Aldino Di Chiano indossa per voi l'elmetto dei centurioni romani. Originale?
Ave Shuffle.
Muori Turi. Te?
Te saluti.
Senti che profumo di vintage, di pelle usata da Pentagon. Abbiamo trovato anche lo spolverino originale di Matrix. Ecco a voi Aldino Neo Di Chiano. Se tu gli spari, lui schiva la pallottola.
Sembra anche un po' maniaco.
Finalmente è giunto il momento della numero uno dei nostri oggetti preferiti di Pentagon, Oslo, Norvegia. Nonostante sia semplicemente un mito il fatto che i vichinghi avessero delle corna sull'elmetto, noi abbiamo scelto questo. E quindi ecco per voi, number one, Erik Di Chiano. E che si fai anche un po' il bicipite, no?
Sarà comodo. Un bel 10 kg a corna qui, eh. Mi sta spaccando la testa.
So what about the market? Like, what do you come to buy? What here? Like, it's like vintage.
Both vintage, and then there are, because on the second floor here there's an art school, like a one-year art school.
Okay.
So many people make their own stuff.
Huh.
Like, I don't know, knit stuff, or they make purses or jewelry.
Are these the people that do the guerrilla knitting?
If there is anybody doing it, that should be them.
It's them, right?
Yeah. They would like also make, they made the chandelier here, you know, so
very
they just
nice,
kind of
very nice, yeah.
Inhabits the area.
He called for his needles and he called for his wool and he knitted himself a crown. Why, baby? Ring a ring of roses, a pocket full of poses. Knit one, pearl one, we're gonna knit right now, everybody!
So this is the end of the market.
Yeah, it's also inside and yeah. And it's like a full day of just things happening.
Yeah.
Both food, things that are made, and
nice.
Secondhand, and concerts.
Nice.
Frank. Snort, do I pronounce it right?
Yes.
Snort.
Snort.
What's the story of Snort? Is that a fictional name? Or?
It's a fictional name.
Yeah, but mostly. Who was Frank Snort in
Frank Snort
imagination?
Still is the former tambourine player of our band.
All right.
He's never been the leader of the band or anything like that, but he was a tambourine player.
Yeah.
And we figured that his name, we called him Frank Snort. You can imagine why. And and we found out it was a good name.
So you are sort of like a living institution at Blå. I mean, it's spelled Blå, but I think it's called Blå.
Yeah. That's
Blå.
Very correct.
You've been playing like every Sunday for a long time now.
Here we have been here for 5 years.
Okay.
We have played other places around Oslo.
All right.
So we have been going for more than 14 years now.
All right.
Yeah.
But is it this gig at Sunday at Blå? It's like a something that you know it's for sure it's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen.
Right.
For sure. First gigs was in Kampala, when we went out in the woods of Kampala. It was the drummer of the band and the trumpet player. They were decided that we have to do some gigs outside.
Where is Kampala? Is it in the countryside?
In Uganda.
Oh, you played in Uganda?
And they wanted to go and play in the streets, sort of like, you know, to play for
the like a buskin.
So they set up in the woods. Just beside a little river. Road for bicycles, you know.
All right.
And they started to play there. And, you know, we knew that they were there. After a while, everybody came up. But it was very hard to get the people attention in the middle of the jungle.
Right, right.
New tambourine player from Uganda.
All right.
And he brought us there initially, that's 7 years ago, to meet his mother.
All right.
And his family. So we went down there and we've been going to Uganda on and off since, and we've had this cooperation with the brass band down there. And now we're getting a little bit of government funding to do...
This is a big social thing, you know, for...
Yeah. Where all the money is! Hey, hey, hey,
tell me about the motto, we fuck up your Mondays. It's very punk rock, I really like that.
It was Blo who coined it, actually.
Really? Yes.
It wasn't us. It was Blo, when we moved here, that needed something to, like, sell our concept with. And I said, yeah, we fuck up your Mondays.
That is very natural. We are a Sunday band playing till midnight and further on.
Right.
So Mondays can be hard to...
Particularly the Monday... This Monday, because I hear this is the Monday where most people go back to work after the holiday.
That's true. I think so. Yeah.
So maybe this is going to be a particularly fucked up Monday.
Yeah, for some people, but not for us.
Not for you. Right. That's why he says we fuck up your Monday, not our Monday.
That's not our Monday.
Our Monday is
already fucked up.
Monday is our Sunday.
Oh, guarda, here they are, the kind of like bachelor party. Or...
No, il canotto, totale. Totale, ragazzi.
And there's another one coming.
There's another one coming.
They will have like the bachelorette or bachelor parties.
Really?
They will go here, stop at Blo, have a beer, and then go back into their boat in downtown.
Like, that's... even this water, I don't know how clean it is, you know.
I think it's quite clean,
it's
actually.
It's okay?
Yeah.
Like, if you fall, we'll be all right.
Yeah.
She's intoxicated by herself. Every day she's seen with someone else. And every night she kisses someone new. Never you.
Queste sono le isole dove venite a nuotare?
Sì.
The one where we're going is?
We're going to it's called Lang Ena. Isole lunghe, è plurale, ma non è solo una. Ma due parti che stanno insieme nel mezzo.
Ah, ho capito, tipo una H.
Sì, e lì si può stare gratis in no tent.
Si può campeggiare gratis su quest'isola?
Sì.
No, comunque ti volevo dire una roba. Cioè, fa abbastanza freddo anche con i vestiti, no? Quindi se ti butti in acqua fa ancora più freddo, o no?
Sì, di più.
Cioè, quando esci fa freddo, dai. Sì. Anche tu avresti freddo.
Sì.
Però?
Però?
Ti butti.
Piace un po' di pain, no?
Ti piace un po' di pain?
Sì, devi prendere un po' di pain. La vita non
è pain, okay.
Solo felice.
È vero, è vero.
Devi sentire che vivi.
Honestly, do many people take a dip into the water?
Yes.
Even there, yeah?
Sì, sì, sì.
But you were saying that Norwegian men, they suffer in silence.
Yeah.
Nobody was going like, you know, Italians, we're like, oddio, freddissimo. They don't say that.
I love that show. I love it.
Yeah, yeah. By the way, I see the crew is very impatient to dive into the water. So, you know, I just want them to enjoy.
Yeah, they're really smiling and happy and looking
water,
forward.
Yeah. C'è già la cuffia.
Yeah. Yeah. Belli carichi, ragazzi, sì. Bella, ok.
Andiamo.
Andiamo, ciao.